Hey guys, what's up? It's Apollo here, and welcome back to another Total War Rome 2 Siege Battle. Now, before we dive into today's battle, we do have a sponsor. This video is sponsored by Displate Metal Posters. Now, I've been working with Displate for a while now, and I love their posters. They're high-quality metal posters. You can see a couple of them on my wall behind me, and I got some new ones I want to show you guys just to, like, really show how high-quality they are. You guys are going to love this poster. Ready? And boom! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So we got a new Lord of the Rings poster. Love the Nazgul. Love the 80s aesthetic here. I love the art. It's fantastic. You can just by listening to it, like, high quality. This is not some flimsy piece of metal that's, like, super thin and it's going to just easily bend. No, it's, you can just tell that it's extremely high quality. And the back here, you've got a hologram tag, which will prove, you know, it's a Displate poster. It's not like a fake or something. They don't use any trees to make these posters. It's just extremely, like, look at this. Like, it's just, they care. You can tell they care when they make their products. It's awesome. So, yeah, they are 100% recyclable. They are super easy to put on your walls. So, when you buy a poster, it will come with this little booklet here. Within this booklet, you will have instructions. I mean, it's like if you can't figure this out, maybe, you know, I don't know. It's super easy. You clean the wall. You will then stick this leaflet. It's like a protective leaf. You just peel it off here and you put it on your wall. You can see I've got some on my wall over here. And then what that does is that it protects the wall from the sticky material on the magnet here, which you just peel this off the magnet. You put it on the leaflet like so on the wall, and then you just simply put the poster on it. It's that easy. And I'm actually moving soon, and I am not concerned at all for, like, any damage to the wall, because it's going to be so easy, one, to move the posters. They're metal, you know, they're not going to tear or bend or break or anything like that. You just grab them, stack them up, move them to your new place, and repeat. You just put them up again. They're super easy. Also, I got another poster. I got to show you this, because they have so many posters on their website. Boom. Of course. I have to get another Napoleon poster. Love Napoleon. Name one character in history that's more epic than Napoleon. I'll wait. But if you go on their website, they've got maps, posters. You know, they got landscape, movie, video games. They have all kinds of different posters that you should check out. In fact, the one with Napoleon that I have here, the artist or whoever made these, the art, he actually has, like, a lot of different famous military leaders, like Alexander the Great. I believe he has a Hannibal one. So, yeah, very awesome, very cool. Now, of course, the holiday season is right around the corner, so there is some big deals going on if you order now. So if you buy 1 to 2 Displate posters, you get 34% off. If you get 3 to 4 Displate posters, you get 38% off. And if you get 5 or more posters, you get 42% off. 42%. That is insane. And this is valid till December 3rd. So you don't want to miss out. You know, get yourself a poster. Get some friends some posters. All you want to do is use the link down in the video description. Use that link. That will automatically will have the discount on it. You know, once you check out getting 1 to 2 or 3 to 4 or 5 or more posters, you will get the certain, you know, percentage off. So don't miss out. I love Displate Metal Posters. I really do. I enjoy working with this company, and I just love their posters. So don't miss out, guys. Thank you so much for watching this sponsor, and enjoy the video. And here we are on the battlefield. So this is going to be a 3v3 siege battle. Now, we do have the attackers here sallying out. I don't know what the plan was here, but he's Misaceli's got, like, these tribesmen units that clearly have vanguard capability. Now, they did get them to waste a bunch of projectiles on them, so there's that. But the Libyan infantry are going to mop these guys up. And you got to be thinking, like, these soldiers in the back of their minds are thinking, oh,
we're just sent here to die. There's no winning this. So, yeah, I don't know what's going on here. Mercilessly charged out two units, and now they're going to die without really getting any kills. I will be surprised. I guess they're getting a couple kills, but it will be quite surprising. Let's see. This one got 16 kills. That's not 19. I mean, like, it's not... It's more than, like, 5 kills, right? But they probably could have gotten a lot more as a flanking unit inside the city. But, hey, that's how we're going to start this battle off. We'll go ahead and do normal speed. Get this one underway. It is a longer battle. I have a feeling that this is going to be a pretty challenging defense here because it's not the biggest of cities, and then you have a secondary layer with a lot of traps and everything. So yeah, it's gonna get a little spicy later on in this battle. So let's really quick look at the factions here. We'll start with the attackers. We have the Seleucids, who's pushing on the, we'll just say the left flank. In the center, we have Swaby, and then on the right, we have the Carthaginians, who are going to be pushing these walls. Now, on the defense, of course, we have Sparta, and then we saw Messacely charge out, and I believe the last faction is a mystery. We won't know until a little bit later, because I just can't see them yet, but yeah, it might be Colchis, I think, or something like that. We'll see. We'll figure it out. All right, well, we already got a breach in the wall. We've got Swaby charging in. He used a tortoise to knock down the wall, and a Messacely is going to meet him with some desert cohort. So we got a nice fight going on in the streets already, and then we've got layers. I was going to say layers. What am I thinking of, Shrek or something? Some onions? No, we got a reserve force, Bloodsword coming in, and it looks like he's going to run straight for Sparta. This actually is an option here where if the Seleucids can pin Sparta down, spicy, and then the Swabians can charge on the flank and get them by surprise, but I expect this unit right here to kind of go here and plug the street. But that's what I would do, and sure enough, we do have the Seleucids charging in. And I assume trying... Wow, they're breaking already? Oh, they're hillmen. They're hillmen, that's why. But yeah, Swaby, come on. You got an opportunity here. Now, oh, it is Colchis. It is Colchis. My guess was correct. So yeah, they're setting up on the defense against Carthage. Carthage has not yet gotten through the walls, but his allies are certainly making a great push through. Look at this over here. They're going to get a great flank on Messacely. This is a huge loss for Messacely. I don't know what they're doing. They probably shouldn't be holding this breach point. And I don't know what Swaby's doing. Why aren't they just engaging that unit? Artillery is coming down on the Spartans as the reserves are getting shot up by fiery balls of justice. And then finally, we've got the Swabians pushing up the Bloodsworn as they will most likely be able to flank around the Seleucids. So this was not... Yeah, this is not an ideal... Well, no, they're going back. I don't know why Swaby's not sending up more troops. I mean, he is now, but he should have had another layer of reserves ready to go in. Because now these desert cohort are going to be able to plug this hole here. And that's why the Bloodsworn had to fall back. And they're going to miss out on the opportunity of flanking the Spartans, which would have been devastating, especially considering the Spartans are spear units. You flank around them, you're gonna get a lot of kills. It's beautiful. So I don't know, they missed out on that opportunity, but the good news is that, oh wait, did they send another desert cohort to try to defend the desert cohort who are holding this? I think they did, which is pretty good. How did that happen? How did Swaby let that happen? I don't know, but here comes Carthage. Carthage has broken down the walls. They're sending in their mercenary Italian swordsmen. They're going to try to keep some desert cohort busy. And you definitely tell that Messacely brought a lot of desert cohort. And there we go. Nice volley in the back. And we have some sword masters who are looking to get some revenge. Now they're going to go after the skirmishers over here, which is a good target to go for. They're vulnerable. They're weak. and they're going to fall back to the safety of the Spartan Hoplites who are holding the center street. But the Swordmasters are... okay, I was going to say they're not letting up, but they are letting up. So this is actually pretty good. They've got kind of... Oh, Colchis. Okay, here we go. Colchis is sending over, shifting over troops as we speak. But I got to say, this defense is a little sloppy. I think they didn't do a good job of defending their flanks very well. And they are very lucky the attackers did not capitalize as much as they could have on this defense. For example, Swaby could have surrounded Masasili's infantry a little bit sooner there. He is definitely surrounding him now, so good on Swaby. Over here, same thing. Swaby could have attacked Sparta right here and would have crushed so many units. It would have saved a lot of Seleucid lives. But the fact that he's kind of holding back here, he's kind of missing that opportunity. So consider the defenders very lucky that they are able to get away with so much with making kind of sloppy plays here and there. There we go. Carthage is flanking around the desert cohort. It looks like they've captured or capturing the gate, which will be good for the attackers. They don't have to deal with the oil. The arrow towers will turn on their side. Colchis is having to reform a little bit. They're shifting over their axemen here to focus on the Carthaginians. Carthaginians have something to say in return as they throw their javies and pursue into melee. And now Colchis is in a very tricky situation. See, at this point, if I was Colchis, I would try to... See, like, yeah, I understand why he pushed up to try to hold this wall, because Carthage had access to flanking the, you know, Masasalian infantry and whatnot. But you might want to call it quits here and fall back. This is a much better position here. But no, he's actually moving up the hoplites. Ooh, don't do that. Yeah, fall back. Reform. I don't think there's any... there's no saving these guys. And if I was Carthage, yeah. Yeah, exactly. Perfect, Carthage. Perfect. Flank around. Get these guys to break. Because it's really what these siege battles come down to. If you have an opportunity to save lives, you gotta do it. And what I mean by that... You're probably thinking, what do you mean save lives? How do you save lives in Total War? Well, what I mean is... If, for example, let's say Carthage, instead of flanking around and hitting this unit, instead they push the hoplites when it looked like they were going to do that. That would mean this unit here, let me use a different color, this unit here would have been fighting this unit for longer without any support, so more of their men would die, even if they were victorious, they would die faster. Unless, you know, he had the flanking unit like he is doing now. So that's what I mean by saving lives. If you can quickly flank and overwhelm an enemy unit without them getting a lot of kills, that's a huge victory, especially as an attacker. So hopefully I explained that well. I don't know. Sometimes I feel like I'm just a rambling idiot when I'm trying to explain stuff. And here we go. Here comes the Seleucids charging in some silver shield swordsmen. Those guys are really good. But yeah, he had the right idea. I don't know why Swaby, even now, Swaby holds back. It's like he's trying to punish the Seleucids. He could easily break this hoplite unit, but he's just letting the hoplite unit rack up a bunch of kills. 97 kills. There we go. They're starting to break though. So I'm sure the Seleucids are like, we don't need your help. There, oh, now they show up. Now that they're breaking. Such cowards. No, only kidding. And see, again, they should have committed them because they stopped breaking. Now over here, the Silver Shields are slicing through the hoplites of Sparta. Just slicing through these guys. Oh my god, please, Swaby, I don't understand the logic here. Why hold back your units in the first place? Maybe he's afraid of the archers up here on the walls? That could be a possibility. It's a pretty cool scene right here. Watching these archers fire away. Hold! We better pray that our infantry holds the streets. No, but it looks like the archers are mostly focusing down the Syrian heavy archers, which is a huge loss for the Seleucids. You might want to hold back the archers a little bit, because that's a losing fight. You are not going to defeat the archers up on the walls. He is trying to go after the Spartan infantry, but yeah, now they're sending up pikemen. Look at that, Seleucids have pikemen. Let's go ahead and see the other parts of the battle, where amazingly enough, they are still fighting. What's going on here? They did not kill the axemen, but yet they disengaged. Okay. I'm gonna be honest, I had a moment there of like, is this a broken replay? Like, I had a moment of, I guess what happened is both players assumed they broke, but they didn't. But seeing that this Libyan infantry came back and threw a javi at them and killed them, that means the replay's not broken. But sometimes, you know, in Total War, if a replay's like not synced up properly, you'll see units just kind of standing around each other, not doing anything, even though they're enemies, they should be fighting each other. So I was a little worried. It's like, oh god, is this replay like totally busted? But no, it's good. It's good. All right, so the axemen trying to hold the center streets here. And then we've got a big push through right here with the light cav, which is okay. Cav can push through, I assume. I don't know. That's what cav does, right? I don't know about light cav, but yeah, he's going to flank the Spartan infantry. They kind of ran through a bunch of units, but I wouldn't consider that too much of a push through. You know, they ran through a pretty spaced out unit. If it was like layers and layers of infantry they pushed through, then yeah, it was a problem. There's a nice little flank there. I don't know if it really did much, but they're going to head back and go for the archers of Masesili, which is certainly a good idea, especially in this type of siege where you want to try to kill as many of their skirmishers as possible, because while they're up here, it's going to be a real pain to deal with, an absolute pain. So this is what, okay, if I was the attackers in this situation, this is what I would be trying to do. One, I would be trying to quickly break through this. All right, you want to break through this quickly because look how close you are to the final stand. That means if you break through here, you can run and cut off Colchis. You can cut them off. And Carthage is doing exactly what he should be doing, which is engaging Colchis. So he kind of has to stay here and fight. So if Carthage was not engaging them, he could easily, you know, obviously fall back without any kind of casualties. But now that he's in the thick of the fight, it's going to be harder for him to fall back. And it's going to be a little bit better for the attackers. But I don't, you know, if I was Swaby, I'd be pushing my men in here, getting aggressive. This is prime time aggressive stage. You know, this is the aggressive stage of the siege. Because like I said, you rip through these defenders, you can cut off this entire army. Now, let's keep a little note here. Look at this. The defenders are sallying out with Hippias Lancers. These guys are really good. We'll see if they can pull something off. I don't know. I think this is a well-timed attack here. Because, honestly, if this was me, like Carthage, I'd be so tunnel vision on the fact that we could cut off Colchis that I probably wouldn't even pay attention. You know, I wouldn't be paying attention to this. But let's see what they go for. It looks like they're going for the African pikemen, which is not a terrible idea, but the pikemen just took their pikes out, so they might have spotted the cav. Or not. They're looking the wrong way. And no, I don't think they did spot the cav. The cav is getting a huge win right now against the Carthaginians, who are losing their pikemen, which is a vital tool for late game, ripping through the defense. And now the elephants are like, wait, hold up. Hold up. Who's this? They're probably not going to catch up to him. You got a couple of the cav units, but they killed like 30 plus men of pikemen. That's pretty good in that quick charge. That's very good. All right, and how's it going over here? Colchis still has most of his forces here. Is there another way up here? No, this is the only way up. Oh my god. They found a gap. They found a gap in the lines. They even snuck some pikemen around the Spartan hoplites through this gap. That's the other thing. You got to watch those gaps on defense. And because of that, oh my god. Please, okay. This is prime time. Rush your men through the gaps. Swaby is making a mistake right here. Oh, there's a little cav engagement over here as well. My bad. Misasily having a little bit of a cav engagement. That's okay. It doesn't matter. That's crazy. Because the Seleucids should be pushing through their men. Swaby pushing their men through here. Why? Well, they should be storming this town center. Storming this town center to prevent Colchis from falling back. But Colchis is still not falling back, so they still have time. And Swaby is making a good move here with this Sword Masters. Honestly, just hold right here. Just hold right there. You'll cut them off. But they, Carthage needs to quickly kill Colchis over here. Clear up the center position. Clear this up so they can get around here. And we also have the Seleucids. They moved up their pikemen. And are taking on the hoplites of Colchis, who are desperately trying to hold this street. Amazingly, the Spartans are still fighting with 63 kills. These are Spartan hoplites. They're sending in Syrian heavy archers into melee. I assume they're out of ammo, but they got to overwhelm this Spartan unit so they can not worry about it. And there we go. There we go. Yeah, I mean, they did it. They did it, guys. The archers are looking for an exit. In fact, some of the archers are already kind of getting out of there. But Carthage needs to go here. Because there's nowhere for these guys to go. They need to go here. And they got to be careful with the elephants, too. Because they're getting dangerously close to this defensive area. And they can easily get shot by, obviously arrows and fire arrows and whatnot. Which, there we go. They are getting shot at. And Colchis is breaking over here. His hoplites are breaking. And it looks like his axemen, his infantry, are struggling up here anyways. They are struggling. Now we have some artillery pieces just blindly firing into the final stand. And again, I don't know why Carthage is kind of sitting here. Because there are archers over here you got to take care of. I mean, this is huge, guys. Seriously, this is huge. The fact that he has these archers out of position, you got to focus them down. You got to storm them down. Kill those archers. Because, you know, you're not going to worry about the defenders sallying out here. Because here's two things to consider, guys. Archers are key at this point of the battle, right? Archers are key. So when he has all of his archers here outside of the defensive zone, you gotta chase them down and kill them. You're gonna save so many lives by doing that. So many lives. Now, you could be thinking, well, if you get tunnel vision over here and, you know, send too many units to deal with the archers, the defenders could sally out and try to surround you as you pursue the archers. That is true, but you'll only win if the defenders leave this area, because you have the Seleucids who could counterflank and kill them out in the open. So I think it's a win-win. You just got to kill those archers. Just got to kill them. But it looks like we're in a little bit of a slow point of the battle, as the attackers have broken through the initial defense and will soon be beginning the attack on the next, or the final defense, the final layer. So we're just going to wait until they commit and attack with full force. All right, guys, so they are beginning to attack the stairway a little bit. I did skip over some fighting because it wasn't too important. So they had some fiery balls of justice, you know, the ball traps that they can have. They had them set up here and set up over here. The attackers did a really smart thing by running up these like tiny depleted units and like broke the traps and caused the defenders to prematurely use the traps. This is why I hate deployables, because 99, maybe 98% of the time they don't work. They don't work. And it's just kind of like, it's just a hassle. They just get in the way. Well, now it looks like they've broken through there. Carthage is now charging the second set of stairs. And the same thing on the other side. You have Carthage and now the Seleucids pushing up pikemen and Swaby. And they are getting really aggressive to try to take out the initial defenses here. Keep in mind, guys, they did not go for the archers over here, which is still has me very confused. That would be my first goal. Because the archers can still be very deadly. They can still be very deadly. And look who's showing up. Oh my god, this is huge. This is the Cav that we saw earlier running down the pikemen. They came back in the city, and they're now going for Swaby's archers, which they left completely undefended. Again, another reason why they should have went after those archers. Because the Cav was with the archers. And now this Cav unit is spanking booty right now. They've only lost like 9 guys, 10 guys, and they've killed 71. And a good number of those kills being longbow hunters. But guys, this is a problem. This is a problem. I don't understand why the attackers aren't going after those archers. Because what's going to happen, at least if I was Colchis, what I would do is like, okay, you're not going to come after me with the archers? Perfect. That's exactly what I want. I'm going to run up my archers and just shoot at the barbarians who usually have light armor. And I'll rack up a ton of kills. Instead of you, I mean, I would have sent fast-moving units like the Cav over here, generals, the elephants. Maybe not the elephants because they might run amok against the archer fire. But I would send all the general units, maybe some, you know, light infantry, and just surround and kill those archers. They're still over here, guys. They are still over there. Anyways, the main fight is still going on the stairways up to the final stand. You can see that Messacely is mostly the one holding here, but Sparta has their reserves holding the initial entrance here, the main entrance. And now we have some skirmishers pushing up as well, coming to reinforce. We've got Sparta who pushed up Spartan hoplites. Okay, I didn't see that. And they are trying to hold against this ragtag force of all kinds of cultures. And now we have the Carthaginians sending up some Libyan infantry, a depleted unit to try to help out here and just send more bodies into the fray. Okay. We've got elephants. Look at this. 2 units of elephants over here. African war elephants. 2? Yeah, 2 African war elephants. Again, oh my god. I don't know why they would leave the elephants on this flank being so close to the archers. You know what else the archers could do? They could run out. It'd be kind of ridiculous, but they... Oh, can they run out this way? Actually, yeah, they can. They can go here, go all the way around, come back this way, and I guess they can't really go through this gate. Okay, that's not really an option there for those archers. But I don't know, like, it's kind of given, like, my OCD is, like, killing me right now. Like, why are they not concerned about those archers over there at all? I don't know. It's freaking me out. I hate it. And Carthage is kind of, he's kind of spamming a little too much here into one area. He's got to be careful because it's making it easy for the archers to rack up a lot of kills. And also, let's not forget that, you know, the men in the back aren't really fighting. They're just getting tired. And now it looks like the Spartans are cycling in and out of units as they continue to try to fight and hold this stairway. And here comes some elephants. Oh my. The question is, they are dying because they're charging into stakes. Oh no. Oh no. Yeah, so you don't want to do that. Oh no, stop it. Stop, Carthage, please. So you don't want to do that. And if I'm one of the defenders, I gotta be like hysterically laughing, like, oh my god, they actually just charged into stakes. So you can destroy these stakes when your infantry gets close to them, and it's what he should have done. But now his elephants are dead, and also they were getting focused down by these slingers. So let's keep that in mind. Even if the stakes weren't there, I think he would have lost a lot of elephants. But what a tragic loss for Carthage. That's a lot of money. A lot of money down the tubes. That's pretty tragic. All right, let's see if they're... Well, the good news is that... Oh, there they are. There they are. They finally reappeared. He's got his Eastern archers. And a lot of them... I mean, I bet a lot of them have about half ammo, looking at their kills, maybe a little less than half. Still, like that, they can still rack up a ton of kills. So, why is, okay, Carthage, why not? Just send your general. Don't send the elephants. The elephants are gonna run amok and just die. I think what they need to do, Carthage here, Seleucids, send your general here, push them together. One general goes here, one general goes here. Boom, you kill the archers. Your generals, I guess they could die, but uh-oh, are these more elephants? Where are these? How many elephants did he bring? And sure enough, look who's running amok. Yeah, this is what I was afraid of. Now, the good news is they're running amok towards the archers. There you go, archers. You can just sit there. I'm rooting for the archers now. I hope they pull off a victory here or something. Yeah, just kill the elephants. That's all they're going to do every time. Every time these elephants... Oh, did he just... He just executed them. He just executed his elephants. Guys. Is there infantry back here? Oh, it's the cav. Okay. Well, that changes things. Because now... So that's why I said you should bring the generals and some infantry to deal with this cav. But I cannot believe either, did these guys die or did he press kill elephants? Because when you have the elephants, you have an option, right, to kill them. So if they're running amok, they don't run amok into your own men. But the way that they all instantly died makes me think he pressed that, even though he shouldn't have, because there was no friendlies nearby. Oh my goodness. Poor, poor elephants. Carthage is just not having a good day. You know, we've all been there. I'm not trying to pick on them or anything, but that's a tragic loss for the Carthaginians. And it looks like most of the Carthaginian infantry is gone. They are gone. And here comes more Seleucids as they push up. We've got Swordmasters sitting in reserve. The Carthaginian elephants are making another go for it. Will he learn from his mistake? It doesn't look like he's learning from his mistake. And dead elephant. Oh boy. Oh boy. What is happening here? Are they gonna die? It looks like the stakes are not killing them now. I don't know, maybe the stakes don't kill elephants. But they certainly slow them down for slingers to kill them. Which is exactly, yeah. So maybe it wasn't the stakes that killed them. But still, you should kill the stakes because, oh, and they're running amok. And look who showed up. Look who showed up with Cav. Whoa, baby. Oh man, they're going pretty deep in enemy lines. Look at that, they're going for the archers. They're not gonna get there in time. They're too far away. This is a bold move by Colchis. I would have waited. Now this cav unit's screwed. They are surrounded. There's no way they're gonna pull off anything here crazy. And the Seleucids still have their pikemen up here. It's still a big old battle. Looks like Swaby has sent in a lot of sword masters into the fight. And now Carthage is just sending in their general. Which again, why? So you might be thinking, well, it doesn't matter because the Carthaginians don't really have any more troops. But you kind of need the cav units to kill the archers over here. And he's just throwing his cav into the fray. And if I'm Colchis, I'm going to be feeling pretty damn good. Oh my god, I would have killed those archers ages ago. They would have been dead a long time ago. But it looks like they killed the cav. Colchis' cav that went in deep. But the balance of power is still in favor of the attackers. They can still pull this off, and here we go. Here comes the general. He's not going to go for it, though. The Hippias Lancers have arrived. Almost full strength unit. And also, let's not forget there. Oh, and we have... Oh! Surprise, surprise. That's something I didn't expect. Yeah, you never send in your general alone. Again, every time I mentioned, you know, send the generals, I said bring infantry with them. And look at Swaby. He's just like, nah, I'm not going to help you. Let's see how long it takes him. Do 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 do. Come on! They still have not reacted. And if I was a Seleucid player, I'd be like, Swaby, you son of a gun. What are you doing? Please send your sword masters and kill these guys. Really? This is how it's gonna be? Swaby? You're gonna let your ally's general die. Oh my god. Swaby just don't care. He's like, whatever. Whatever. See ya. Wow. Guys. Okay, I'm gonna be honest here. If the attackers win this battle, it would be unheard of. I really think the attackers have lost so much. And, I mean, the balance of power says they can certainly win this, but... They've lost like 3 units of elephants. They've lost 2 units of generals carelessly. And the archers are still alive over here. And the archers are now... Hey, you got nothing to worry about. As archers, I mean, I guess you could worry about the enemy archers. That, you know, the Swabian archers over here. But if I was controlling the archers, I'd move them up now and go for this blob of infantry. The infantry that just stood by and watched the Seleucid general die. Oh my goodness. And the Seleucids now are breaking. Word is getting out. Hey, did you hear about our general charging in YOLO style into some enemy cav? And Swaby was like in helping distance and didn't move up his troops? No, it happens, guys. It really does. And I'm only joking. I don't want to sound like I'm being too hard on the players here. I say it in a jest form of way. A bit of banter. Just having a little fun. Because there's been many, many times when I play Total War and someone's like, hey, Apollo, idiot, can you send these guys in or something? Or, you know what I mean? Like, I've had many times where my ally needed me and I was not paying attention. I assume Swaby was probably just focused on the fighting over here. He did not see his ally's general getting cornered and just slaughtered. But it is what it is, and it happens, again, and it's something to learn from. I think map awareness is pretty huge in siege battles, and I think that's one thing new players are kind of surprised about, because with siege battles, you think it's pretty straightforward, you know, it seems to be a little less micro, Which, yeah, I think there's less micro in a siege battle, but you know what there's more of in a siege battle compared to, like, a pitch battle is map awareness. In pitch battles, there's not all these, like, streets and walls and different pathways you can take and opportunities, but in siege battles, there's a ton of streets and walls and opportunities where you can, you know, surprise the enemy. So map awareness is probably one of the biggest things in siege battles in Rome 2 that you need to have. And you're always watching, always looking at every street and trying to guesstimate what your opponent's going to do. But guys, I mean, considering all of the blunders for the attackers, they can still win this. They can still win this. I mean, the balance of power is still in their favor. Only just, but it's still in their favor. And looking at the defenses here of the defenders, we've got Royal Spartans, two units of Royal Spartans. One's pretty depleted. Not like super depleted, but kind of depleted. He's got some noble infantry, Nubian noble infantry. And then he's got the Colchian nobles. He's got noble units, Colchis nobles. And then some archers in the back. That's not too much. That's not too much. Now, let's not forget, they've got archers over here. Never forget. So we'll see, like, when they come about. But let's see, are they using their bows here? Or are they waiting? Longbows are not firing. I think they're waiting for maybe Colchis' archers to show up.
Why you come on?
Not really sure why the Spartans sallied out some Royal Spartans over here. I love hearing the dialogue of the soldiers during the battle. That's one of the coolest things that I like in the newer Total Wars. Though I wouldn't call Rome 2 a newer Total War. I guess it is, relatively speaking. But yeah, I love the... Oh my god. Another sneaky cav charge going after the archers of Swaby. They're like panicking. They're running around looking for the nearest exit, and you've got some sword masters trying to hold down the Nubian riders, or is it raiders? The riders. And there we go. They're going to kill them. So they didn't kill too many of the archers, but that was certainly a good charge by Misesili, getting that surprise attack on the archers of Swaby. All right, here comes the Seleucids again, still pushing. They're pretty much using all of their best units. They've got pikemen. They've got the silver shield swordsmen. And with that combined force, they're going to try to rip through these defenders. Rip through them. And yeah, it's down to Swaby and the Seleucids, the double S's. Swaby and Seleucids. And let's not forget about Sparta. Triple S. Huh? Sparta on the defense. And it's really up to Sparta, I guess. I mean, Colchis has some units that they're pouring in. I don't understand. Okay, so like, I think as a defender in this situation, what I would do... is let them come in a little bit. I would have formed a box here, like that, with defenders, or even a V shape, like that. And I would have let them come in because you would then be able to put your archers up on the walls and they could fire at their backs while your infantry let them in a little bit. And you can also, let's not forget, the infantry on the flank, well, attack the flank. So I would have done that instead of just holding this, you know, straight line here. But we'll see. We'll see how that plays out. Let's not forget about the archers either, which the shield bearers are well aware. We got some sword masters, so they're kind of holding the flank. And I believe they do still have some cav alive over here. I still can't believe they didn't just focus those units down. I mean, talk about crazy. Just crazy. That would have been, again, go back like 10, 15 minutes ago when they were like setting up all their forces here. Before even attacking this area, I would have chased down those archers because They didn't have any infantry. They had cav and archers, which are pretty deadly, but if you have infantry going in with cav, there's not much they can do. So, yeah, we'll see if that bites them in the butt later on in the battle. But for now, they're holding the good fight. They're fighting the good fight. We'll kind of fast forward here a little bit, as we're not watching anything like tactically interesting, as they are just duking it out here. We'll go back to normal speed. Now, Sparta is starting to waver here. Again, I'm kind of surprised that Sparta like pushed up. Like, I would have all the forces lined up on top of each other, not kind of pushed up. And now Swaby is moving up his archers. So I think Swaby is going to try to support with the archer fire in the back. The Seleucid's still going strong here, though. Swaby has some sword masters in the mix as well. I don't know, guys. I think the attackers will... Okay, if Colchis didn't have his archers or cav, I would say the attackers most likely will win this. Because they're starting to run out of infantry. Now, let's not forget Sparta. Okay, well, hold on. Sparta still has troops here. Colchis has his general here. They still have a lot of layers of troops. This is kind of not allowed. It's kind of frowned upon. That's called a push through. That's a push through by Swaby. But that's okay. It could have been an accident. Sometimes it does just happen by accident. And the Seleucids are starting to break here. Their sword bearers are breaking. They have 131 kills. Syrian heavy archers. They were tossed into the fray as well. Can they hold? Can they hold? Back up this way, we've got Swaby with the Swordmasters going in. So Swaby's sending in some reserves. Where is Colchis' archers? I mean, I know they're being very patient. And look, they're even sending a artillery crew to kind of find them. But I'm curious. I wonder if they're able to, like, sneak this way without being seen. That'd be pretty impressive if they could do that. Imagine the archers just show up behind Swaby and just starts firing at him. That'd be pretty chaotic, pretty fun. We'll see. Swaby coming up with extra reinforcements. And this right here, this is the ultimate grind fest. Okay, this is the battle of attrition, where both sides are trying to sparingly use their infantry to break or hold this choke point. I love this. Wow, look at that. The statue in the back, that's so cool. Oh my god, that's so sick. Look at that statue. What settlement is this? I usually don't play settlements with like an inner defense. So I don't know what settlement this is. Here comes another charge of troops. Just getting some cool angles here. This awesome statue. And look at, they're breaking through. But hey, look what they're doing. I think they're finally doing what I was mentioning, is letting them come in a little bit. And now, see, the Spartans will have a flanking opportunity on the left and right flank. Dang it. I was not paying attention. It looks like the archers killed the artillery crew. So the archers are still over here. Just waiting. And sure enough, it's getting pretty chaotic over here. Hold! Oh my god. That's sick. The statue is not pleased with the defenders. Oh my god, that's so cool. I love getting these close-ups. All right, here comes another charge with archers, which tells me the defenders are running out of ammo. All right, now is the time. I'm sorry, but now is the time you got to move up those archers. Colchis's archers. And there they are. There they are. And here's the cav as well. Did not expect them to come from that angle. They're killing some swordmasters, just trying to finish them up. And yeah, the archers are going to have a huge blob that they're going to be able to fire into. There we go. This is I like this because I've never seen this before. Of like a group of archers coming from behind during the last stage of a siege battle. Alright, here we go, here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go now. And there they go, they're gonna open fire. I'd go for that general. I'd go for the general. All they have to do is hold here. It's all they have to do. Can you hold? I don't know, guys. Holy crap. There's some straight up crazy photography here. I love that statue just sitting back there watching. Just watching. Now the archers charging in again, giving support to the infantry. Just throwing bodies at the attackers. And look at this, guys. We had the cav charge in. So this is the Hippias Lancers trying to kill as many as possible. We got some archers over here who are, I assume, trying to come back and support, but they are wavering. And yeah. They ran out of ammo already. Okay. So I guess these archers didn't really have that much ammo anyways. But still, I mean, they had a decent amount when the elephants attacked them, right? They had enough to scare off the elephants. But these archers are going to be a good flanking infantry. And, oh, look at this, though. Swaby's not having it. This is a good move by Swaby. Trying to scare off the archers. But the general is away from the front line, which could cause some issues. Let's zoom in again and get some juicy close-ups. Oh. I like watching units fight archers because they generally get a lot of the kill animations. That's sick. Oh, he's like, no! Look at these guys. How could you kill our friend? Oh, they get revenge. Sick. Very cool. And there we go. The archers are coming back. They were chasing down some enemy archers that were breaking. Wait, what's going on here? Where are these guys going? Where are they going? No, they're needed near the front. And now we have the general coming in. And this might be it. This might be the push to try to overwhelm the defenders. See if they can do it. Look at the Spartans trying to hold here. Bloody Spartans. Just getting some cool footage time for the Spartans.
Understood.
Look at that. That's sick.
Yes, come on. Understood. Orders understood.
We will hold and defend the statue. This guy's clean over here. He hasn't seen a lot of action. Get the new guy in there. Anyways, let's look at what's going on with the battle. So they're still holding. They're shifting around units. Oh, is that? No, yeah, the Misaceli is shifting around. Looks like Sparta might hold on this flank here. Nice rally. And now, oh, this might be a deal breaker here. Let's see if these archers can break through the Swordmasters. I doubt it, but you never know. Oh, you know what I would do? I would shift. Instead of just charging all in, shift one unit to go around. You can flank around here. Just one unit. Oh my god, Swaby coming in with troops coming out of nowhere. That's kind of huge. Uh-oh, Colchis starting to break. I think that was Colchis's general. Oh, this is close. Uh-oh, we got, what is this? Shield bearers forming up, and they're trying to get a little bit of a charge bonus there. That was a nice move by the Seleucid forces. I guess they were able to get units behind the enemy. They were going to form up and then, I guess, charge in. This is so close. This is extremely close. Less than 4 minutes left in the battle replay. The archers are still alive. Sparta's still alive. With their general with over 200 kills. 228. These Royal Spartans have 326 kills. Sparta's so nasty, man. So nasty. Look at this fight. The statue sees all. But Sparta breaks there against the shield bearers. Pretty elite units going at it. And now these shield bearers are going to be able to flank around. This might secure the victory for the attackers if they can pull this off. Boom. Boom. And now we have the archers of Swaby holding the back flank, the rear flank against Colchis's archers. And there's also oh, there's no way. Where did these guys come from? I swear, Swaby's like cheating. They got units just spawning over here or something. And there we go. They hit. I think that's going to be it. Oh, no. Colchis's general is still in it. I thought Colchis's general died. But looking at what's left, I don't think they have enough. I think Swaby is going to take it with the troops that they have. I'm pretty sure all forces are engaged here. This is it. This is down to the wire. Who's going to take it? It's looking pretty good for the attackers, but it's at the point where all it takes is a chain route, and it could be anyone's game. Sparta and Colchis stand together. Let's see, how many kills? 272. Impressive. Colchis with 104 kills. And that's it. That's it. If the Spartan general breaks, that is for sure it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's game. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward as Swaby is going to overwhelm. And of course, Seleucids have a unit in there, but the Seleucids are about to break. Well, hold on. I mean, again, I doubt. Well, I mean, who's winning here? Unit winning. Okay. The general of Swaby's beating the general. Well, now it's saying combat even. Yeah, there's no way. There's no way. So we'll fast forward and watch the Swabian soldiers do the deed. And there you have it. They're wavering. And this is going to be a defeat for the defenders, a victory for the attackers. Let's end the replay and look at the results here. So, yeah, great game. I believe this was sent in by the Seleucid player. definitely had some mistakes in this battle, but that's okay. That's mistakes, or you just learn from them, you move on, and they're quite fun to see because you could, the viewer, you guys can learn from them. But that was a great battle. I mean, it did start off really shaky for the attackers, but they were able to pull through and get a victory. And Swaby over here with 3,000 kills. My God. So really good job on Swaby. Good job to the defenders. Was a great fight. Colchis, honestly, I thought Colchis was going to get more kills, but look at his archers. His archers racked up so many kills, and a lot of those kills are elephants. But GG to everyone. This was a lot of fun. Again, thank you to Displate for sponsoring the video. Again, look in the description and there'll be a pinned comment of the Displate link. Get yourself an awesome poster. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you next time on the battlefield.